those of you who are seeing the video online.
There's a little issue involving 50 rogue commemorative Buzz Lightyear action figures stuck in toy mode that will make considerable problems for everyone. At ease, gentlemen.
I'm here to scan the Honda Center to locate your leader, Elio.
To share with you Star Wars Skeleton Crew.
23, this is so cool. What a nice room. You have no idea how excited I am to be here again. I'm so excited to be here today to talk to you about the second installment of our show, Andor.
What's it like playing Riri?
I have been having the best time playing Riri. And I can't wait for you guys to see more of this series.
Charlie Cox. When you all entered tonight, you were given a black envelope. Can you all hold the envelope up in the air? Oh wow, you all followed the instructions. You did not open it, thank you. Can everybody rip open the envelope? Just rip it open. And this is my first time at D23. Can everybody do just like I do? Everybody open up the box and take all the cards out and all do this. Everybody, what I want you to do is I'd like you to cut a group of cards, a little group of cards, and turn over to a card. If your card is the five of spades and you're matching me, the odds of that is 1 in 52. Can you all? Oh, wow, here we got some matches. Great.
I think I got the matches.
But that's only a benefit if you do. Everybody put that pile face up as it is on top of the face down deck in your hand, just like I did. So now you have your card face up, just like me. Let's say you cut 10 cards, the next time you'll cut 20. In other words, you're gonna cut deeper than you previously did. Everybody turn over to a new card. Cut deeper, turn to a new card. If you matched me twice, the odds of that is 1 in 50,000. All right, everybody put this pile with your new card facing up on top of the pile that's face down in your hand, just like me.
The lady with the striped shirt,
do you want to use the face down or the face up pile? Face up or face down pile, it doesn't matter. I hear it down. Okay, great. So everybody go through the cards until, through the face up cards until you see the first face down card. Just like me, everybody, yes. And put the face up pile on the bottom. You can leave it face up. Good, just put your face up pile right on the bottom so it looks like you have a face down pile. Did everybody do that? Okay, can everybody take three cards, 1, 2, 3, and put them on the bottom just like I did? Everybody take three cards and put them on the bottom just like I did. Now take the next card and nobody look at it. Take the next card and hide it under your leg so nobody can see it, not even you. Everybody hide it so nobody can see it. This is the first time that 12,000 people have ever done an interactive card trick in one room, so thank you for being here with me. Now, Noah, I'm gonna run through the cards, and I want you to try to see one inside, but you can see that they're all different. Yes, they're all different. So I'm gonna run through like this. I want you to look and try to see one in the middle, okay? Can you see the cards? Hey, I'll do it again. It's too fast, just try to see one. If you get one, number and suit. Don't say it if you get one.
Yes.
Okay, you're gonna choose a card.
Okay.
And that will be the card. So here, take the card out. Take anyone. Good. And don't look at it. Can you say your card out loud?
Three of hearts.
It was a three of hearts. She's holding your card. Would that be impressive?
It would be.
Can you show everybody what card you have?
Oh.
Oh, wait. No, what I mean is she's holding the card. She's holding the card. What I mean is, hold that up so we can see. I'm saying the queen is holding the card. Look at the queen's hand.
Wait, what?
You also see the queen is holding the three of hearts. Not only is the queen holding the three of hearts, but you all took a card that you all hid.
It's the same, and we do.
We don't talk about Uno. No. And do you know what else is unbelievable?
What's unbelievable, Mayor?
Lynn has never been to a D23.
Yes!
D23, please welcome the one and only.
Songs went, and it was just such a joy to be in service of one of our great directors. So.
I could talk about these songs all day. Do you just want to hear one? The D23, just for all of you in this room, you're going to see a clip from the film featuring a portion of a brand new song I wrote called I Always Wanted a Brother.